Being an INFJ and one of the 16 Myers-Briggs personality types is both a blessing and a curse. For example, being introverts, INFJs possess a rich view of the world, and they're extremely caring and empathetic in nature. However, INFJs also run into a bunch of problems, often directly related to that deep empathy and concern. Hey guys, welcome to another exciting video from our channel, Brainwatched. In today's video, we present to you why it's difficult to be an INFJ. But before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us. Without further ado, let's take a look. These issues aren't something that is exclusive to INFJs, which means that the other types may also experience something similar. However, they're extremely common and frequent for this rare personality. Complete strangers confide in them within seconds of meeting them. There is something about INFJs that makes them share personal information with strangers. Maybe people sense their understanding nature, which for some reason makes them instantly desire to share very personal information with the INFJs. This is not always problematic, but it can be jarring when someone that they just met is suddenly telling them how they never felt loved by their father. INFJs feel worthless if they can't make others happy. As INFJs, they want nothing more than to make others happy. Some INFJs have been known to sacrifice anything and everything for their loved ones, as long as it brings a smile to their faces. This, of course, can lead to burnout and resentment sometimes. The problem snowballs when they realize that they can't help even though they really want to. INFJs may plunge into a sense of worthlessness, which can have far-reaching consequences in their self-esteem and quality of life. They feel oh so old, but also very young at the exact same time. It's said that INFJs have old souls, they just sometimes feel very world-weary, while they restlessly seek inner peace and meaning in everything that they do. Complicated, right? It's not necessarily depression, although INFJs have been known to struggle with this mental health condition. Rather, it's more of a bittersweet melancholy, as if they have been alive for over 1,000 years. But at the same time, they love to laugh and dance too. This perpetual tug between youth and maturity is definitely a source of internal conflict for them. They're easily drained by other people's emotions. INFJs' keen inner senses quickly pick up on what other people are experiencing or feeling. They're then likely to adopt these emotions themselves, which then complicates wanting to make others happy. This is, of course, helpful when deciding on a course of action or debating on what to say in a certain situation. They usually bottle up and hide their emotions, but then an explosion happens. In true INFJ form, they rarely want to bother others with their feelings. Some INFJs may even view their emotions as a burden to others, so they keep it all inside. However, INFJs are only human, and eventually the feelings need to come out. And when they do, it's essentially an avalanche of epic proportions that nobody saw coming. Even worse, they will probably immediately feel guilty afterward. INFJs need to be reminded that expressing their emotions is healthy. They can come off as clingy and needy. Here's the thing, INFJs are incredibly loyal individuals, and when they love more deeply and fiercely than even they can fathom. They desperately want the people in their life to feel appreciated. However, this behavior can also backfire, as constant communication and how are you doing okay can be seen as clingy sometimes. They overthink themselves into an existential crisis. Overthinking is a major hurdle for almost all introverts, and the INFJs are no exception to this. Sometimes what begins as an innocent thought into how to solve a problem quickly spirals into a full-blown existential crisis for them. Once they're stuck in this crisis, it can be extraordinarily difficult to escape. They cry easily. This one is especially problematic, as it often happens at every inopportune or embarrassing moments. Like all feeling types, INFJs are prone to random tears. It can happen anywhere and at any time. People think that they're strange and aloof. Other people regarded INFJs as a little odd. And let's face it, INFJs are a tad unpredictable. Nobody knows if they will catch us beaming with happiness or crying our hearts out. Since we're so turned inward and focused on emotions, we can sometimes come off as rude or distracted. Whether you experience just one or several or all of the above problems on any given day, it's important to remember that you're not alone. Keeping your head held high and embrace your gifts and sensitivity, the world needs INFJs like you. With that, we come to the end of today's video. Do let us know in the comments section below. If you enjoyed watching the video, then do leave a like and share it with your friends. For more such videos, hit the red button below and subscribe to our channel. Also, don't forget to click the bell icon to never miss out on any future updates. We hope to see you in the next one.